pleasure.
Hi there, this is Clark Terry here, reminding you to pull your bearskins a little closer to the fire. That's it. Now you're talking to me. Watch out for those snapping sparks. Everybody cozy? Now, the good news is that you're in time for the humble farmer. You've worked hard all day, and you deserve to relax now. So stay right there and listen to the best of this kind of music.
Trumpet stays up to my mouth. Oh, I'll tell you a matter, indeed. And if you say it's necessary, baby, I'll even hear how I see. Ha, ha, ha. Oh, be your buttered egg, man. Want some great big buttered egg, gal, want me.
Hi there, your buddy the humble farmer here with an hour of old-fashioned music just for you. Thank you for listening. People who slide off the road and into a tree while on their way to the ski slopes might have an ambivalent feeling about a wicked big blizzard. But whenever I see a picture of a field covered with newly fallen snow, I remember what it was like to lie on my back out in the freezing cold and replace the rear end in Russ Thomas's school bus. Snow is never a pretty sight. Anyone who has frozen their hands and back while trying to complete some project sees a snowy landscape through unique and experienced eyes.
Thank you.
little thing. Come on and let us bring joy in the new days. Bing, out go the blue days. Sing, just like a bird in spring. And let the echo ring way up to heaven. Song is king, this life is cold. Unless we have that certain spark, it's all controlled by music. So from morn till dark, be a lark and just sing. And you can have your fling, accomplish anything, if you would only sing.
I'm pretty sure that it was our friend Etienne, the Camden jeweler, who sent me a lifetime subscription to the J. Peterman's Owner's Manual. You heard me talk about this before. The J. Peterman's Owner's Manual is no more than a catalog of very pricey exotic items. What makes it interesting is the description accompanying each item, because instead of describing the item, it paints a picture of what you will be doing when you're wearing the $158 lacy flannel skirt. Probably having tea with the Duke of Hastings, or lugging off a sack of money you've just won from James Bond in the Casino Royale. If you're familiar with the Owner's Manual, you know that it contains some very silly but psychologically very powerful writing. It's an intentional satire on itself, I think, and it's obviously very successful. Well, I showed this Owner's Manual to some gifted high school kids up Lewiston way, and I asked them to advertise a product with that kind of writing. This is what Olivia wrote. The strong musk scent of wood chips and flannel mixes with the smoke of the hickory wood in the hearth. He walks over to the sturdy oak table and places his axe next to it. His wife has placed hot chowder in front of him. His masculinity radiates, but has not yet been achieved entirely. Well, not until he reaches for the bacon bits. That was Olivia. I think it's fantastic. Thank you. While making two radio shows the other day, I was plagued with forgetfulness. To begin with, I forgot to push a certain button that makes the formants hop, those green things. And when I played Honeysuckle Rose, I honestly thought it was Flatfoot Floogie. I couldn't figure out how the song could have gotten twisted around on the CD, and I puzzled over it while it was playing until my head seemed to get it right. Then, I couldn't remember how to convert the file from MP2 to MP3 or whatever it is I have to convert it to. I recently had to download a new program that did this conversion, and I couldn't remember that I had that program or how to even find it or what it was or where it was. I'm asking you, could it have been just a bad day? We always heard stories about old men who couldn't remember if they were going to the store or coming home. I've looked up Estero several times. That's the name of a town in Florida, Estero. But I keep forgetting what Estero means. I hope I have it this time. I think it means foreign. I'm not sure. And the other day I was thinking of the word hubris. Hubris is a word I read from time to time, but I will be darned if I can remember what hubris means. I can look it up, and then I forget it by the time I've seen it again. Kids no longer study Latin or Greek, and it's too bad, because what you learn when you're young is likely to stick right with you for the rest of your life. I work on my Italian about every day. I read Italian. I read Agatha Christie in Italian. And I work on 50 tough Italian flashcards. I have 1,000 of them, and 950 of them are pretty easy, but there's 50 I can't seem to remember. I don't seem to be gaining a gosh darn inch on them. Now, the other day, I rode my bicycle 11 miles while listening to my Dutch friend Bone reading Agatha Christie in Dutch. I've heard this for the umpteenth time, and even though Bone goes pretty fast in some places, I have that pretty well down. So there's hope for my Dutch. But I'm concerned about not being able to remember simple things. What experiences have you had with forgetting things? Could it happen to you? I'm the humble farmer at gmail.com, and I'd love to hear from you.
I dream of brownie with a light blue jeans. She is as sweet as licorice jelly beans. I dream of brownie, and with passion I burn. For of all the smiles I've seen, there's none like her. When my nights are lonely and go from bad to worse, Brownie sings for me, and I thrill to her verse. She makes me happy, and she makes me feel merrier. Brownie is my favorite white-haired terrier.
I love Brownie better than Jeanie. I love Brownie better than Jeanie without the hair.
I will not forget the night I called.
I looked for Jeanie's light brown hair and found that she was bald.
Thank you. dream of Jeannie with the... She is so that I could almost... I dream of Jeannie with the... Every time I look at her, I... Every time I see her, I could almost... Every time I see her, I...
Diddy-ba-doom, diddy-ba-doom, boom.
I dream of Jeannie with the... Jeannie is my queen, for I love her so.
Here's your humble farmer tip for the day. You heard me mention it a week or two ago, but you might agree that it's worth repeating. This comes under No Things Considered. Hopefully this will enrich your life. Years ago, some people carried knitting with them, knitting baskets. This knitting enabled them to do something productive while they were in an environment where the only option was to sit. Nowadays, some people carry a small book when they have an appointment at some office where they might have to wait. Of course, that way, they're sure of having something that appeals to them, and they won't be stuck with Sports Illustrated or some hot rod magazine. Time spent in a doctor's waiting room is never wasted if one uses that time to brush up on Shakespeare or read the preface to any one of Shaw's plays. I have a friend who attributes his fantastic education to the fact that he was always sick.
my heart with pride. You say your black bottom show is what? Well, your black bottom dance is all you got.
There was once a crook who stashed his cash in a cache. My Facebook friend Craig says, college is not a cache. It is where you learn words like cash. In the beginning, a young wife thinks her husband is God. Then she realizes she is dyslexic.
like a shimmy like my sister gay. Shimmy like a jelly on the plate. My mama wanted to know last night, say, why old Kate treat the boys so nice? Every boy in the neighborhood knows your shimmy is understood. I know I'm little late, but shimmy like my sister gay. No job in shimmy like my sister gay. Oh, booty, bitty, booty, bitty, dog, oh, saddle, zaddle, zaddle, skin, bitty, bitty, bop, bop, dog, put a little, bitty, well, well, put a little, lot, dog, skinny, bitty, bop, zaddle, zaddle, oh, baby, shimmy like a sister, kid, no jobbing, I shimmy like a sister, kid, oh.
A friend writes and says that she'd like to visit me and my wife Masha, the almost perfect woman. This is easy enough to do. All you have to do is come to our house. Our address is on several dozen web pages along with our email and telephone number. Visitors are always welcome. If you want to be sure we're here at home, call 207-226-7442 and say you're coming. Hey, Humble, we're on our way over. Hang on there. If we are not here, I promise you that we will not answer the phone. The other day, the phone was out all day because I put a new $2 desk in my office and I couldn't get the Wi-Fi to start working again when I hooked it up again. If Masha is lucky enough to have a cleaning job the day you want to come, you can either come another day or you could visit with me. I like visitors because visitors enable me to get things done that I might not otherwise do, like stack wood or organize the clutter in my office. Unlike many people who do not like being bothered by guests, I enjoy visitors because I am strong enough to entertain them and enjoy their company while engaging in some constructive project, like, as I say, stacking wood or organizing my office. Mindless chores, of course they are, that enable me to give my friends the 100% attention that they want and deserve. Knowing that the last time they visited, they spent 4 or so hours helping me pick up shingles I just tore off the barn, well, it gives my friends the feeling that they are a welcome part of our family. Many can't wait to come back again.
Way down among Brazilians, coffee beans grow by the billions, so they've got to find those extra cups to fill. They got an awful lot of coffee in Brazil. You can't get cherry soda, 'cause they've got to sell their quota, and the way things are, I guess they never will. They've got a zillion tons of coffee in Brazil. No tea or tomato juice, you'll see. No potato juice, 'cause the planters down in Santa's all say no, no, no. A politician's daughter was accused of drinking water and was fined a great big $50 bill. They got an awful lot of coffee in Brazil. Need savor. Coffee ketchup gives them flavor. Coffee pickles way outsell the dill. Why they put coffee in the coffee in Brazil. No tea, or tomato juice. You'll see. No potato juice. Cause the planters down in Santa's all say no, no, no. So you'll add to the local color, serving coffee with a cruller. Dunking doesn't take a lot of skill. They got an awful lot of coffee in Brazil. Man, they got a gang of coffee in Brazil. Hey, Pedro, get a flashlight, I cannot find any sugar.
It is true that some writers welcome something to write about. I'm one of them. Yes, some authors might get out a book without ever leaving their own backyard. And I saw a book the other day entitled 38 Household Plants That Even You Can't Kill. But what would Marco Polo have amounted to had he sat around home? Mark Twain saw at least some of Europe and the Sandwich Islands. And we have read that it was on his honeymoon that Robert Louis Stevenson wrote Travels with a Donkey. Now, I'm not saying that this is true. I'm only saying that I once read it. Without some form of chaotic stimulus, a writer is nothing. So send me a note and tell me what you've been doing today. I'm thehumblefarmer at gmail.com, and I want to thank you right now for writing.
Thank you.
playing with Doggy, I find I can get him to drop the ball at my feet if I pretend to throw another ball. No matter how many times I do this, Doggy falls for it every time, which might indicate that Doggy is no smarter than men who have been married 4 or 5 times.
Send me a note and tell me what you've been doing today. I'm thehumblefarmer@gmail.com. Thank you very much for writing. And here's Brad Terry again. You like Brad Terry. Your friend Brad Terry, who lives in Bath, Maine. If you're lucky, he you get to see him play around the state from time to time.
While putting off making a radio program one day, I exhausted about every possibility for continued procrastination until I realized that I could play with the Wi-Fi all afternoon trying to get it to work. You remember hearing me tell that after putting a brand new $2 desk in my office, it entailed shutting down the equipment and hooking all the electronic equipment, hooking all the wires up again. And when I did, the Wi-Fi didn't work, I couldn't get it to work. I wasted all one afternoon, and I wasted the entire next day trying to get the Wi-Fi to work. Now, you know I'm not just talking. I'm going to tell you something you might need to know. Please pay close attention. The day after that, I plugged in the Wi-Fi, and it worked slick. A Wi-Fi is just like an old man. If you don't keep bugging it, and if you leave it alone for a day, it will eventually get around to doing whatever it is that needs to be done. And I hope my wife is listening to this program.
This next tune is a song that we've been playing this one for a while, but this kind of sums up the kind of stuff that Joe and I sort of came to agreement on. Been playing together for 27 years, and I think one of the reasons why we started playing as a duo is we both like swing music and old tunes from the 40s and stuff. And we came across this group called Slim and Slam back in the 40s. They were a fun, kind of a novelty group, but they were great musicians, and this was a hit they had, and we did it on the first recording we ever did. It's called the Flatfoot Flugie. Flatfoot Flugie with a flower fly. The Flatfoot Flugie with a flower fly. The Flatfoot Flugie with a flower fly. A float jar, float jar, float jar. Flatfoot Flugie with a flower fly. Flatfoot Flugie with a flower fly. The Flatfoot Flugie with a flower fly. A float jar, float jar, float jar. If you're feeling low down, got no place to go, blues is hanging around your door, just sing this song and they're bound to go. Flatfoot Flugie with a flower fly. Flatfoot Flugie with a flower fly. Flatfoot Flugie with a flower fly. A float jar, float jar, float jar. Bing bang boom, here we are. Bing bang boom, here we are. Bing bang boom. Swing with us. Come on, honey, got to sing with us. Flatfoot Flugie with the floaty floaty. Flatfoot Flugie with the floaty floaty. The Flatfoot Flugie with the floaty floaty. A float jar, float jar, float jar. Flatfoot Flugie with the floaty floaty. The Flatfoot Flugie with the floaty floaty. The Flatfoot Flugie with the floaty floaty. A float jar, float jar, float jar. If you're feeling low down, you got no place to go. If you got the show down, here's the only dance for you. Flatfoot Flugie with the floaty flow. Flatfoot Flugie with the floaty flow. The Flatfoot Flugie with the flow.
joy, full joy, full joy.
The fruity with the flower, flower. The flat, the fruit, the fruity with the flower, flower. Flat, the fruity with the flower, flower. Full joy, full joy, full joy.
What do you do with your Facebook page? For me, Facebook is a very useful tool. Facebook takes the place of many letters I got from you and my wonderful other wonderful radio friends 30 years ago. People don't buy stamps anymore, they don't mail letters anymore, but a few send email and some write on Facebook. Craig is a Facebook friend. I think he lives in Washington, D.C. Craig wrote this on my Facebook page. Craig says, "Wouldn't it be wonderful to invent a new way to make money off procrastination or another human foible? I remember the time when I realized that my local video rental store was actually in the late fee business, and the tapes were only a means to achieve that business model. My family sustained it with hundreds of dollars of fees, but we didn't watch all that junk on TV. We rented that junk. I think all the foibles have been taken, but perhaps we could open a nice padded gym area where people could jump to conclusions." Don't you like that? A padded area where people could jump to conclusions? I'm Robert Scoglund, the humble farmer. With any luck at all, I'm here every week at this time right here on your favorite channel playing old-fashioned music just for you.